We are on Nida Perek Yud Mishnah Vav, sixth Mishnah, in the 10th chapter of Masechet Nida. This Mishnah is going to talk about a case of Yoshevet al Dam Torah. Yoshevet al Dam Torah is a woman who gave birth. And remember, she has, depending on whether she had a boy or a girl, 7 days or 14 days of Yemei Tum'ah. And then either 33 days or 66 days of Yemei Tahara. Yemei Tahara, she means the blood that she sees is still Dam Torah. So she's Tahara, but the problem is she's not totally Tahara. How do I know? Let's go to Vayikra. This is Zefariah, Vayikra, Perek Yud Bet. Woman has a baby, okay? She's Tama, she has a boy, Tama, she's At Yamim. She's Tamei for 7 days. And then, Ushloshim Yom, Ushloshet Yamim, Teshev V'Demei Tahara. Any blood she sees is called Dam Torah. Remember, this is only Tahara of the Beit HaMikdash. Now we don't have Dam Torah, etc., etc. But even though the Torah says Demei Tahara, she's Tahara, nonetheless, B'chol Kodesh Lo Tiga, she can't touch Kachim. V'al HaMikdash Lo Tavo Ad Lo Demei Tahara. And she also can't go to the Beit HaMikdash. So she is Tahara, but not 100% Tahara. So what is her status? So the Mishnah says, He tvulat yom, the din of tvul yom. A tvul yom, remember, is a kohen became tameh. He's a rishon tuma. He has to go to the mikvah. He's tvul, tvila, from the mikvah during the day, but he has to wait till Ha'erev Shemesh, till the night. So the status of someone who goes to the mikvah, but it didn't come night yet, is like an in-between status. Okay, why? Shetabla l'sof shuvah ayim. It's like she went to the mikvah after 2 weeks, meaning she had a baby girl or whatever. But she doesn't have what's called Ha'arev Shemesh, where the sun goes down, until the 80 days. Okay, meaning, because she can't bring her korban. And therefore, she has specific halachot regarding what can she do and what can't she do. So she is the status of what's called Tevulat Yom, and therefore, at the beginning we're going to say originally, and therefore that had a limit on what she could do, says the Mishnah. Barishona Ayuomer, originally they said, Hayoshevet al Dam Torah, when who gave birth. And now she's in the middle of her status of Dam Torah. Let's say she had a baby girl, and now she is 66 days of Demei Tohar. Haitama Ara Maim LePesach. She could pour the water to wash the Korban Pesach. Let's look at why is she allowed to do that? Says the Bar Tanura, since she's a Tvul Yom, Tvul Yom is a din of a Sheini Letuma. And since she's a sheni l'tumah, she me'ara, when she pours, eina nogad b'mayim ela b'kli. She doesn't touch the water, she touches the kli. And a sheni, eina matam b'kli. So that's a problem. They're preparing the Korban Pesach, everybody's doing things, she can draw the water. Aval b'mayim lo tiga, she can't touch the water. Because the water is being used for Pesach. And Chulin shenasu al tarat hakodesh kikodesh dami. This is called chulin shenasu al tarat hakodesh. Chulin done. The water is chulin. You're drawing the water for chulin, but you're using it in order to use for the korban, and therefore it's like kodesh. And therefore she can touch the kli, she can touch the vessel, but she can't touch the water itself. And then that's barishona originally, but then chazul amar no. Harehi kimagat meimet lekodshim kedivrei beit hillel. They changed their mind and they said she's not a tevul yom. She is like Magat Meimet. Meimet is an Avatuma. Magat Meimet is a Rishon Letuma for the purposes of Kachim, Kedivre, Beit Hillel, point following the position of Beit Hillel. So that's only for Kachim. So this is based on the Gemara. It has a whole like long thing. So the Bar Tanura is sort of like, the Bar Tanura is summarizing the Gemara. And the Gemara says, yes, for Kachim, for Korban. Avalechulin, no. And this water that she's preparing is Chulin water. Why? Because you're drawing it, even though you're using it to be used with the Korban Pesach, it's still chulin. So the Gemara says what they meant was, even though she's a Rishon Letuma, and if she touched the water, she would make the water tameh. Nonetheless, chulin, later they said, chulin shenasu al tarat kodesh, lav kekodesh damu. The chulin of this, for use for the Korban Pesach, that's not kachim, and she could touch the water itself. Beit Shammai Omri, Beit Shammai said, Af ki Tmei Meit. No, they made her like, her din is not even like a Rishon, even like the Tmei Meit, like an Avatum. And the Beit Shammai is like, you can't touch the water at all. But nonetheless, this is all, okay, therefore, Maga Osho Tvul Yom is Rishonu, and therefore she couldn't touch the water at all, probably even couldn't touch the vessel. But again, this is all talking about in the times of the Beit HaMikdash, what they originally thought, and then later they said, Chulin Shenasu Al Tarat HaKodesh, Lav Kekodesh Damu. That's what he says. The Bar Tanura says that was the maskana. If you make chulin to be used with kachim, it's not like kachim, and therefore the woman who gave birth, she can handle the water. Hope you got all that. We'll stop here. Dedicate our learning To the memory of my father, Reb Simcha Ben Yitzchak Kalman. Make it a great day.